The thin middle layer is called a buffy coat. It consists of white blood cells and platelets. The white blood cells, leukocytes or phagocytes, are larger than red blood cells and are irregularly shaped. They contain granular leukocytes, which make up 65% of the composition and produced in bone marrow. Agranular leukocytes make up the rest, 35% of the composition, and are formed in the lymph nodes. They both show amoeboid movements. Leukocytes' main function is to make up the body's defense mechanism by actively seeking out and digesting bacteria and producing antibodies that destroy bacteria and neutralize their toxins. Phagocytes have lobed nuclei. They reach the site of infection and form pseudopodia or false feet. It then engulfs the bacteria and the site of infection becomes inflamed. Dead tissue, dead and living bacteria, and phagocytes form pus. This pus is harmless, dries up if left untouched, and falls off. The second component of buffy coat is platelets. Platelets are tiny pieces of cytoplasm with no nucleus, but most cell organelles for regular function. They are normally present in the bloodstream in an inactivated state. When platelets encounter a break in the epithelium, they activate with the help of various molecules like collagen, which is not present in a healthy blood vessel. The collagen is one of the thrombogenic compounds that are responsible for platelet adhesion. It's turning the platelets sticky to each other and forming a platelet plug. An inactive protein, also called a factor in the blood plasma, is converted to an active proteolytic enzyme. The active enzyme in turn promotes the next step. Finally, after a cascade of events, prothrombin is converted to the active enzyme thrombin. Thrombin then acts as a cofactor that helps convert fibrinogen to fibrin. The resulting fibrin molecules begin adhering to one another and assemble into long fibrils. This long network of fibrils stitches platelets together, forming a stronger, more permanent clot to the damage.